I'm Gert Peters, product specialist at Hyundai. We are here at a test site at one of our European customers where we are testing the HL975A CVT machine. It's the twin sister, if you like, of our HL975, but the major difference is the transmission. We have a CVT, continuously variable transmission, which is very fuel efficient, especially in short loading cycles. But even if you are just running a lot of hours and you're doing load and carry, or you have longer cycles, you can also benefit from this CVT in terms of your total cost of ownership. Let's have a look at the business end of our wheel loader. So that's of course the bucket. Here we have a 5.2 cubic meter bucket of a Hyundai installed. These machine sizes, normally they have a fixed mount bucket installed because you don't often change your buckets when you're working. If you do that, it's also possible. We have a quick coupler system that you can install. It's an ISO standard, so whatever bucket you might already have will also fit on this machine. In terms of boom, this is our standard boom, but we also have an extended boom available. If you are, for instance, dumping at a much higher dump rack, normally two hydraulic lines use up the power. One for the bucket, one for the boom, but you also have a third hydraulic line available for whatever other attachment you might have. That's where the power is going. Let's see where the power is coming from, and that's the engine. See the engine? I just opened up the engine hood. It's quite easy. You get access to the engine, the aftertreatment system, and all the other service items. You can easily see it. It's a Cummins engine. Now, for all our heavy machines, excavators and wheel loaders, we work together with Cummins. It's a very reliable brand, easy for a customer to just go to our Hyundai dealer. You can service the machine and the engine together. So that's quite convenient. Cummins is very fuel efficient, and they have a special aftertreatment system we are very happy with. They have the DPF, so our soot filter, DOC, diesel oxidation catalyst, and the SCR, our red blue system, but they don't have an EGR anymore. This CVT, it's for a unit, it's new, but it's a proven concept. It's a ZF transmission, so it's not the first time that it's actually being used in the field. It's actually a combination of two things. We have a mechanical transmission, where you have a fixed gear ratio, and you have a hydrostatic transmission. CVT combines both, so you get the benefits of both. We see a lot of fuel efficiency improvement, especially in short cycles. We see that up to 30% of fuel is saved if you use the CVT machines. So as you saw, the engine hood opens up electrically. It gives you access to everything you need to access. Especially the maintenance items are quite conveniently accessible. Let's open up the machine a little bit further and have a look. As you can see, easy access to all the filters to do your regular maintenance. So that's for the outside of the machine. Let's go and have a look inside the cabin, what we can see there. The cabin is very spacious. You have easy access here. You can lock down again the armrest, move it in four ways, up and down, front and back. Now sitting in the air suspended seat. It's also heating, so it's just very convenient here in the cold weather. But most of the things that are happening with the machine can be seen here inside the cluster. With the CVT come also a number of new modes and settings that are possible in the cluster. One of them is the traction mode. Because you have so much traction going to your wheel, you have the risk, if you're working, for instance, in a muddy environment, that your wheels will start spinning. In this case, you can reduce your traction going to your rims by just reducing the percentage of your traction. That's one possibility. The second mode that we have here is the creep mode. Without pushing the accelerator pedal, your machine will not move. If you prefer to have it moving slightly or very slowly, you can activate the creep mode and the machine will move at, let's say, 2 kilometers an hour. Third new possibility here is the dynamic mode. Normally the engine goes no more than 1615 RPM. That's all you need for the CVT. That's all that's necessary to work in the fuel efficient part of the engine. If you do need more, if you do want more, for instance, if you need more hydraulic power, you can activate the dynamic mode and you will have more power going to your hydraulics as well by increasing the RPM up to 1800 RPM. So that in terms of the new modes that we have. Something that we have on all our Hyundai wheel loads is our integrated weighing system. You know at all points how much is in your bucket, how much you have loaded. Very interesting to know, for instance, to avoid overloading of your trucks. For further improved safety, we have a lot of extra options. One of them is our Aavm system. Aavm consists of two parts. Based on four cameras, we have a 360 round view and an iMod system. iMod is intelligent moving object detection. So if something is moving around your machine, it will be indicated on the screen to avoid any accidents. Another option is also our rear radar detection system that will indicate any objects that might come behind the machine. So especially if somebody's moving behind the machine, it will be told on your screen that someone is there. In terms of service, everything that the maintenance concerns, you can follow it up in the cluster. You know when your maintenance has been done and when it's due. We see that most people will use the Highmate telematics system to follow up. Highmate is our telematics system where you can remotely access on a laptop, on your mobile phone, you can remotely access all the information on the machine. That in terms of maintenance, but also in terms of productivity, fuel efficiency, machine location, when it's been working, how long and how hard it's been working, everything can be seen there, easily accessible. In our wheel loaders, we always use the electrohydraulic control, which means you are using an electric signal to control your hydraulics. Last but not least, in terms of fuel efficiency, there's a lot that the machine is doing to improve it, but there are also a number of things that the operator can do. And to help him with that, we have our eco gauge, where you can exactly see how fuel efficiency is working to possibly change the behavior or the way he's using the machine. That's one thing. Finally, we have the option of the automatic engine shutdown. We see that often a lot of wheel loaders, they're idling for a long period of time. For instance, if they're waiting for a dump truck, you can see that. And to help with this, we have our automatic engine shutdown. You can change the parameter so that after a set amount of time, the machine will automatically shut down if it's just idling, it's just waiting there. So that will also help you with reducing the fuel you used.